Thank you everyone for joining World Footprints today. I'm so pleased to introduce our guest, Francesca Donlan, who happens to be a personal friend of ours as well. Fran serves as the communications director for the beaches of Fort Myers and Sanibel in Fort Myers, Florida, which is where she's joining us from now. And she's also an adjunct professor at Florida Gulf University, currently teaching the kindness effect. And we'll learn a little bit more about that later. But Fran, I want to thank you so much for joining us tonight.
You're my pleasure. I look forward to talking with you.
So how are you, first of all? How are you and your family?
So we are fine, but like the rest of the country, we are just, we're frazzled. We're like everyone else. We live in a tourism community surrounded by beaches, and the beaches are closed and the restaurants are doing takeout. And I have two kids who are supposed to be in college who are now in college in this house, and a husband who and I both work out of the house, and we're all four here together with our two dogs making this new normal work. I mean, we're happy to be together, but it's very different. It's different.
Indeed. So are all of the beaches closed in Florida? Because we've seen on television where many of the beaches are open, particularly, you know, Miami, South Beach, and they're crowded.
So as a result of those pictures where you saw mostly spring breakers, the beaches are closed. Miami, Fort Lauderdale, and we just closed our beaches last week, Fort Myers Beach. The beaches that are open, Sanibel and Captiva, but the parking lots are closed, and they don't want anyone on their beaches. I mean, if you're staying at a hotel, you can have access to the beach, but you have to follow the CDC guidelines and stay 6 feet apart and not have more than 10 people in your party 6 feet apart. So there really aren't really too many people on the beaches here.
Well, I mean, talk about the difference a few weeks makes. When, you know, just a few weeks ago, we were together in Sanibel Island, you know, in paradise. But those places you said are still open, Captiva Island, Sanibel Island, they're still open. Is it because there's residents on those islands?
Well, yeah, I think it's just because they're islands and they're comprised of so many miles of beaches, and it's not densely populated, and it's not a spring break attraction like some of the other beaches, like Fort Myers Beach or Miami Beach, or but you know, that's probably going to change. I mean, I'm guessing we're all just going to have to get in some lockdown at some point. We're our state's got a high number of cases, and I think we're going to follow suit in the other states like New York and Connecticut. I think it's Connecticut and Illinois. There's a lot of them who have decided to do that. And I don't think we're far behind.
Yeah, I'm sure our state, Maryland, is not far behind either. It's like they're trickling down almost. So what changes have you guys, you and your family, made what changes have you adopted at home in order to stay at home, and you know, as a result of this outbreak?
Yeah, so it's tricky. I mean, I've got a teenage daughter who wants to see her friends. I've got a college, I mean, you know, and my son as well. And now we're home. And so my mantra to get through this, and we have been, you know, we're Floridians, so we've been through the hurricanes. We've had our challenges for sure. And so the two things that I get through all these emergency situations are exercise, and that could be just a walk around the block, and kindness. And I say that because both of them use the same chemicals, you know, the same feel-good chemicals that you get exercising, you also get them being kind. So I think in emergency situations, when there's high anxiety, depression, and everything is a little unsettled and unknown, then I lean into those two things, exercise and kindness.
Well, speaking of kindness, I mentioned that you teach this at university, at the university level. One of the things I am very surprised about is how fearful how people are allowing fear to replace logic and kindness and humanity, and people that I will smile at, you know, even my building frown at me and kind of, you know, walk the other. I mean, there's that much fear tied to this virus. And so what are some creative ways people can demonstrate kindness and humanity while maintaining a social distance?
Yeah, so people are tapped into some real fear for sure. And people are scared because this is something, these are uncharted waters. And there's so much at stake right now. So for me, the first thing that I do is I am kind. If I have to go to the store, those baggers and those checkout folks, they're just getting pummeled. And so I'm just as kind as possible to them. I had to go to Costco this week to get supplies, and they had us go in, they had us line up in the carts, and then we would go in like in waves of five, let's say. And I just kept telling the Costco folks, like, thank you, and you're on the front lines too. And they just were like, oh, thank you for saying that. Like, I feel like everyone should be saying that. You know, I mean, they are on the front lines. If they're not there risking their own well-being, we're not going to get food. So anyway, that's just a little tiny thing, but I try to do that every day. I also am kind to myself. I teach my students that, you know, we're all working really hard and we're you know, I don't have small children. I mean, in Florida, like other states, I have colleagues and friends who are working full-time jobs at home and now having to homeschool small children. You know, it's just untenable. So I think that you have to be kind to yourself, give yourself, you know, whatever that means for you, meditate or take deep breaths or go for that walk or isolate yourself in the bathroom if you have to, you know, just to just get centered. So there's that. And then I think there's going to be more and more things that are going to pop up that we can help. But right now it is tricky to figure out how to help. So my class, we collected 500 note cards from the community, and they're right now writing the note cards, and then they're going to give them to the nursing homes. We have 4 nursing homes, and we got permission because they're on lockdown. And we have a special way that we're going to deliver the cards, and then the social directors are going to, we've got the cards for everyone in each facility. So 125 to each facility. And then the social director is going to read the cards to each resident, you know, and they're not just like, love ya. They're like, hi friend, we're thinking about you. We care about you. We know you can't, it's a hard time, but, and to have my sweet, you know, students who are in their 20s, early 20s, and I've got three older-ish students, but mostly in their early 20s, when they're getting such a bad rap right now and for spring breakers and, you know, I won't let a coronavirus, you know, prevent me from partying kind of thing. They're so sweet and so kind, and they're so excited to do this, and they love their grandparents and they want to do this. So I think we can do that for our medical people, our fire people, I think we can start doing that for all those people who we appreciate.
That is a wonderful idea, and especially for the elderly, because many of them are without family members, and so they're already isolated to some degree. So I think that is a beautiful, beautiful gesture. Thank you.
Well, I can't wait, and I think one of the students is going to put together a little video of it, so I'll share it with you, like please. The kids writing and then taking it to the nursing homes and then the nursing homes opening, you know, letter. So
please,
excited.
Thank you. Now, I know you mentioned one of your kids, one of your daughters, I think you said, is really eager to connect with her friends. Yes. So What are some creative ways she is connecting with her friends, and in ways that maybe you're connecting with your friends and family, that, you know, and even celebrating special events while practicing social distancing?
So we're all just stuck at home doing, you know, sort of Skype and, you know, this kind of thing. But my daughter told me a really cute thing that she saw some other teens doing somewhere else, is that they're all driving their cars and they're parking in a circle so that they can see each other, but they're not touched, you know, they're not near each other, but they're like texting each other in their cars around the circle. So I thought that was really, really cute. But so for me, so I have a writer's group, and we are learning how to do social media, and we're having our meetings online where we can see each other like this. And it took us a minute to figure it all out, but we're going to commit to meeting twice a week and doing like an hour of writing and then Skyping or whatever to talk about it and make ourselves accountable. Mm-hmm. So that's how we're doing it. But family and my mom, and it's just the phone, FaceTiming everyone. We haven't had any special celebrations. I feel like we've really just been in this a week. But I have a friend of mine who wanted to get married, and she doesn't know how to do it because she can't get a license. So anyway, I just thought that was creative, you know? She has to think of, just to wait.
Bless her. Well, they don't sell marriage license online, I don't think.
No, they don't.
Oh, bless her. So you mentioned a little bit ago that you do some exercise. You know, I wanted to ask you about something that you did today, which was you mentioned you were dusting off your bikes and
yep.
going out for a bike ride with your husband. But you commented that not everybody can do that. What did you mean by that?
Well, I feel like, you know, we're in Florida, Southwest Florida, and it's sunny. It's 80 degrees here. So we can get on our bike and go, you know, to the 7-Eleven, you know, whatever, if it's even still open anymore, and just get out. And we also have parks that are open still. So you can, as long as you're adhering to the CDC guidelines, you can go to the park and walk around. They're still open for now. But you know, people live in some really, really cool places and they can't hop on their bikes and they can't go for walks. And so, you know, I feel like we have that luxury that other people don't have. But I think if I was trapped in the house, I'd just do something else, like have a dance party or, you know, do yoga or, you know, I think you have to just get your blood running a little bit to get those endorphins that we all desperately need right now.
Mm-hmm. Agreed. So when this is all over, and I'm praying that it's soon, what is the first thing that you'll do or the first place you'll go post-coronavirus?
So I think two things. One, I will have not probably hugged anyone besides, you know, my family for who knows how long. So I would like to go see my friends and hug them and go see my mom and hug her and, you know, do that. And then I'm a beach person, so I would go to the beach. But if everyone's going to the beach, I'll wait a day to go to the beach. But I think that for me, I'm an extrovert, so I would go find my people.
Yes.
What about you?
Well, pretty much the same. Beach, travel, just really dine outside. I want to dine outside.
Yes, travel. I should have said that too. Yeah, like I hope that everyone, you know, the poor in, tourism industry is taking such a hit, as is so many other businesses and industries. But I hope that we can all get back on trains and planes and go give some love to our tourist destinations.
Yeah, well, yeah. Especially the lovely destination you hosted us at just a few weeks ago. I'm assuming they're closed.
No, they're open. South Seas Resort on Captiva Island is still open. Yep, everybody's still open for business. I mean, it's thinning out, as you could imagine, but nope, they're there.
Oh, nobody wants to leave paradise. I wish we hadn't.
I know. I'd like to get trapped. We could have gotten trapped there.
That wouldn't have been a bad thing. Although, you know, I would have had to send for my husband and my cat, and
you know. They would have made room. They would have.
Well, Fran, thank you. Thank you so much, my dear, for joining me this evening and for sharing your experiences and for sharing kindness and the importance of kindness, especially in today's world.
Yeah, can I read you one little paragraph that I read today that was really touched me?
Please.
So Maria Shriver has a Sunday paper and she writes sort of inspirational things. And this is what she wrote today.
Okay.
We are all, each and every one of us, a diamond, a crystal, a ray of sunshine in another person's life. We are each desperately needed at this moment. Our light is needed. Our ray of hope is needed. Our joy will make someone's day. We've got to know that.
Oh, lovely. Thank you.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yes. Beautiful way to end this meeting with a beautiful human being. I so appreciate you.
Thank you, Tanya.